up there first, and you can back in statistics to refute some of the claims made in that article. Between 2012 and 2013, there were In 2013, there were 4,631 vehicle and traffic stops. Of those stops, only 171 led to drug arrests, for a total of 3.6%. And that is actually down 13% from in 2012, when 4,000 stops were made and 167 drug arrests were made, for an average rate of 4.1%. The statements by the police officer, well, drugs were found in every car, every time you made a police, every time you made a traffic enforcement stop, was absolutely outrageous and incorrect, and now that we have the facts, we can get them out to you. I also wanted to point out that a Peekskill police officer has not fired his weapon in the line of duty, except for training purposes, in more than 15 years. And that's only as far back as we searched, not because we found an incident that happened 15 years ago. Heroin in 2013 resulted in 72 deaths in Westchester County. And at the time of the News 12 report, not a single death was attributable to heroin in Peekskill. However, on Friday of last week, the Westchester County Medical Examiner ruled an October 2013 death was a result of heroin. So of the 72 deaths in Westchester last year, only one occurred in Westchester. I'm sorry, occurred in Peekskill. The News 12 report, unfortunately, made facts up to dramatize their report. Officer Bazo said duck, but he never used the words, "Oh, your head will be blown off," as the reporter indicated. Officer Bazo approached the stop vehicle without his hands anywhere near his weapon, contrary to the narrated report. Her statements in this report unfairly portrayed the city of Peekskill as a lawless, modern-day Dodge City, an injustice to every law-abiding citizen who works, lives, and invests their money here. I'm extremely disappointed with the unnecessary dramatization of this very important issue that faces our society by News 12. We are a small city. We have the same problems as a large city. I do not deny that. But the statistics, which is the evidence, shows that our problems are not nearly the same as those in Mount Vernon, which is a similar-sized city. We're not even on scale to the cities of New Rochelle and Yonkers. In fact, our heroin problem resulting in deaths is no greater than the heroin problem in the affluent county cities of Garrison, Creighton, Cortland, Yorktown, and Ossining. We have a first-rate police department whose members work diligently every day to protect and serve our citizens. I, together with the entire city council and the residents of Peekskill, fully support our police department. We give them the necessary tools to do their job in a fair, appropriate manner. It is unfortunate that this expedite was authorized by a young chief who's only been on the job for 1 year. He made a mistake. He did this without the knowledge, permission, or consent of the offices of the mayor or the city manager, and featured a well-intentioned, yet overzealous, but misinformed police officer. This action has severely tarnished the image and reputation of Peekskill throughout the county. I am disappointed by this incident, but I can tell you that we have taken measures to minimize the risk that anything like this will ever happen again. I want to take this opportunity to apologize to the citizens of Peekskill for this event, especially the high tax-paying and law-abiding owners of the Barron House on Main Street and the A&P Shopping Center on Russell Avenue, whose reputations were particularly spurned for no apparent reason other than showboating. I requested Chief Johansson and Officer Basso to make personal apologies to these taxpayers, but unfortunately, I lack the authority to order them to do so, otherwise I would. The actions that we have taken in response to the News 12 report are as follows. Together with the city manager, we have revised the city rules regarding press contact, press releases, and communications by the chief of police. Effective immediately, all contact with the press, and that's all contact with the press, shall only be made with the prior approval of the city manager. All press inquiries shall be referred to the office of the city manager for response and not individual departments. The City of Peekskill will be joining the Westchester County Police Department's Northern Westchester Drug Initiative, along with Yorktown, Croton, Bedford, Mount Pleasant, Mount Kisco, and Austining. And we have directed the Chief of Police to follow all Westchester County Police Department protocols in the interest of public safety. And lastly, all Peekskill police officers will be advised of all statistics involving arrests by the posting of the monthly reports on the bulletin board in the police headquarters so that all of them are aware of the statistics so they are not misquoted in the future. If anybody has any questions, I'll take them.
Thank you, Mayor. It's important for me to be here today. As you heard, County of Westchester Police is going to be joining Peekskill in the enforcement of this unfortunate increase in heroin and other drug sales in Northern Westchester in general. I represent not only Peekskill, but Portland and Yorktown. And I'm here as the county legislator, but I'm also a lifelong resident of Peekskill, former mayor, and I'm just concerned in particular about my community. Nothing to address the video. It was an unfortunate decision to have produced. But I'm here to help the city of Peekskill in the enforcement of the drug sale